Hi students, today we will discuss the topic of combinational circuit. In the digital electronic field, the logic circuits are divided into two categories. One is sequential circuit, the second one is the combinational circuit. In case of sequential circuit, the output of the A circuit is always depending upon the present inputs as well as the past inputs. Whereas coming to the combinational circuit, always the present output is depending upon the present input combination only. Let us see what exactly this combinational circuit is. Generally, this combinational circuit is consists of three components: input variables, output variables, and set of logic gates. So these three will be used to build the combinational circuit. So let us see the block diagram of the combinational circuit. If you see the combinational circuit block diagram, there you can find the n input variables and the m output variables. So this is called n cross m combinational circuit. So there are the n different kind of combinational circuits that were used in the digital world. Let us discuss some of the things. Now the examples for the combinational circuits are off adders, full adders, multiplexers, demultiplexers, encoders, decoders. Now here the question is how this combinational circuit was designed. What was the procedure to design the combinational circuit? Let us discuss the step-by-step procedure of the combinational circuit. See, these are the five steps are used to design the any combinational circuit. The step one in the combinational circuit design process is, first the problem has to be clearly stated, what was the underlying problem. The second is, after go through the problem, we have to identify the set of input and output boolean variables. And once this input and output boolean variables were identified, for them we have to assign the letters or the labels. So once this input and output variables were identified, the relationship has to be built with the help of the truth table, where this truth table will show the relationship between the input and output variables. For an input combination, what will be the output? Here the input variables generally it can be m and the output variables can be n. So once the truth table is derived, so for every output variable we have to derive the boolean function. So once this boolean function was derived, simplified boolean function was derived, for them we have to draw the logic diagram. Now let us discuss the combinational circuit which illustrate the entire step-by-step procedure of the combinational circuit. So let us take the off-adder combinational circuit. What exactly it will do? So that is what we have discussed earlier. There are the five steps are there in the combinational circuit design process. The step one is the problem definition. The step two is what? We have to identify the input output variables and we have to assign the letters, and then the truth table has to be derived. So once the truth table has derived, we have to derive the simplified boolean function for it, for each output variable. So once the simplified boolean expression is derived, for them we have to draw the logic circuit diagram. Now let us discuss the what exactly the problem definition of the operator. So this combinational circuit is used to add the two bits. So for example, two bits means we will have the four combinations 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1, 1 plus 1, sum is 0, carry is 1. So this is what the problem definition of the off adders. Now, if you go through the problem definition of the off adder, there we can identify how many input variables are required, how many output variables are required. As the problem itself gives the meaning, the op adder is used to add the 2 bits. So we require the 2 inputs, let us say A comma P. And we also require the 2 output variables, one is the sum and the second one is carry. Now the step 2 is also over, let us move to the third step. So in the third step we have to draw the relationship between the input and the output variables. So here the input variables are A and B, the output variables are sum and carry. Now let us draw the truth table A, B, sum, carry. If A is 0, B is 0, then sum becomes 0 and the carry becomes 0. If 0, 1, the sum becomes 1, the carry becomes 0. 1, 0, sum becomes 1, carry becomes 0. 1 plus 1, then sum becomes 0, the carry will be 1. So the truth table is also over. Now we have to derive the Boolean functions for the sum and carry. So you are well aware of, to derive the Boolean functions from the truth table, we have to consider the min terms which will give the high voltage or the logic 1. Now for sum here, 0-1 combination is giving the 1 and 1-0 is giving the 1. Whereas in case of carry, the 1-1 combination is giving the 1. So we have identified the min terms. Now it is up to us, the Boolean function which came from the truth table can be simplified either by using the postulates of the Boolean algebra or by using the tabular method, that is what came out. Now in this problem we have the 2 input variables, so obviously we will use the 2 variable k-map. So the 2 variable k-map will be used to derive the Boolean function for the carry and the sum function. So if you observe the input combinations of the op adder, let us consider the sum output variable. So for the sum output variable, for the 2 min terms, the truth table is showing the logic 1. So what are those? 0-1, for 0-1 combination the logic is 1, and for 1-0 combination the logic is 1. So let us consider the min terms which gives the 1. So let us plot those values in the k-map. So as it is a 2 variable k-map, let us plot the min term values. So this is what the k-map for the sum output variable. Similarly, let us plot the values for the carry output variable also. So if you observe the carry output variable, For all the combinations, the output variable carry result is 0, whereas for one combination, it is 1. Okay. Now, we have plotted the value. So, most of you people are familiar with how to group the ones in the k-map. Now, here, in case of sum, we don't have the choice of group the 4 bits, or we don't have the choice of group the 2 ones. Of course, 2 ones are there which are not in a contiguous fashion, rather than it is what in the diagonal fashion. The diagonal grouping is not possible. So obviously, we will go with the single ones. Similarly, the case with the for also. So the sum equal to AB bar plus A bar B. So this can be write in the another notation, A exclusive or B. When coming to the carry, here we don't have the no other choice, so obviously we will group with the only one, so the carry equal to AB. That means now we are having the simplified Boolean functions for the carry and the sum output variables. So the last step of the combinational circuit is what? We have to derive the logic diagram for the given Boolean function. Now we know the input variables, we know the output variables. So the input variables are A and B. The exclusive OR of AB will give the output for the sum, and if the AND gate is applied between the A and B, the resultant output will carry the carry output variable value. So this is how the op adder is constructed with the procedure. Now let us discuss the one more example to understand the process of this combinational circuit approach. So far we have discussed the half adder. Now we will move to the full adder. So obviously we know that the five steps approach to design the combinational circuit. The first step in the combinational circuit design is stating the problem. Now here the problem at the bottom line of the full adder is adding the 3 bits. That means with the help of the full adder combinational circuit, we can add the 3 bits. So that is what the problem definition. Now the second step is we have to identify the different kind of input and output variables that were used in the full adder combinational circuit. So the problem definition itself, it is clear that the full adder is used to add 3 bits. So obviously we require 3 input variables, and we know that we should have the 2 output variables. One will indicate the sum output variable, the second one indicate the carry output variable. Now we have the input and the outputs. Now we have to derive the relationship between the input variables and the output variables. Now here the input variables are A, B, C. The output variables are sum, carry. Now as we are considering the 3 binary variables, now here we will get the 8 combinations. So the combinations are 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, 111. Now we will derive the values for the sum. 0 plus 0, 0 plus 0, 0. Like that, if you continue for the 8 combinations, you will get the values for the sum. Similarly, the carry, based on the additions, the carry field will be updated. Now if you observe, when 2 ones are there in the input combination, so let us take the fourth combination, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, the 0 will be inserted into the sum column and the 1 will be inserted into the carry column. Why? Because 1 plus 1, 1 0, the 0 indicates the actual value, the 1 is the what? The carry over to the next position. So the carry will be 1. Like that you have to continue for the remaining input combination. Now we have completed the 3 steps, the problem definition is over. We have identified the input and output variables, we have derived the truth table. Now it's the time to, we have to derive the Boolean functions for the given output variables. So here the output variables are what? Sum and carry. Now we have to derive the Boolean functions. So we have already discussed it. The Boolean functions can be simplified with the help of the postulates of the Boolean algebra or the tabular method, that is what? KMAP. Now here, how many input variables are there? 3 input variables are there. So obviously we should use the 3 variable KMAP. Now if you see, first once the KMAP is plotted, we have to plot the values. So let us plot the values for the sum and the carry. Okay, now let us group the ones in case of sum output variable. So if you observe the 3 variable came up, the sum output variable, there we don't have the choice of grouping of 4 ones. Yes, the grouping of 4 ones are there, 4 ones are there, but those 4 ones are not there in the contiguous locations, rather than those are scattered. So let us see, is there any chance for the group of 2 ones? That is also not there. Why? Because those are not forming any square or the rectangle, rather than they can be formed through diagonal. So which is against to the rules of the KMAP. So obviously we will go with the single ones. So let us plot the single ones and let us form the Boolean expression. So the Boolean expression is A bar B bar C plus A bar B C bar plus A B bar C bar plus A B C. So if we simplify this, we will get the C exclusive R, A exclusive R, D. So let us derive the Boolean function for the carry output variable. So if you see here, there we will chance of what? We can group the two ones. So how many combinations will come? Three combinations will come. So after we are grouping these two ones, so the simplified form is AB plus AC plus BC. So we have derived the simplified Boolean functions also. Now is the time for what? So we have to draw the logic diagrams for the given simplified Boolean functions. So the logic diagram for the, this is what the logic diagram for the sum and carry output variable. See, for the sum, we are using the what? The exclusive OR gate for which three input variables were applied, A, B, C. And how the carry was constructed? The carry was constructed with the help of the three AND gates. For the first AND gate, AB inputs are supplied. For the second AND gate, AC are supplied. For the third AND gate, BC are supplied. So the output of the first AND gate, second AND gate, third AND gate will be input to the OR gate, and the resultant is one is what? The output value of the carry. So this is what the full adder. Next we will discuss the one more example of combinational circuit. So let us consider the parity generator. So before we are going to discuss about the parity generator, first we should discuss about the what exactly this parity. So this parity bit is a extra bit which will be appended to the actual message. Why that extra bit need to be appended to the actual message? So in the digital transmission of the information, there might be a chance that the data may be corrupted. Actually, the binary information is transmitted from source to destination. During the transmission, ones may be converted to zeros, zeros may be converted to ones. So in such cases, the receiver will not receive the actual information. So to eradicate such kind of problems, the mechanism was used. The mechanism name is parity bit mechanism. So here two kinds of parities are there. One is the even parity, the second one is the odd parity. So what exactly this even parity or odd parity means? I already told you this parity bit is an extra bit which is appended to the actual message. Now we will see what exactly the even parity and odd parity. So first we will see even parity. Even parity means once you add that extra bit to the actual message, the number of ones in the total message should be even, then it is a even parity. Once you added the extra bit to the actual message and the number of ones in the total message, if it is odd means, then it is a odd parity. So it is the choice with the designer, either he go with the odd parity or the even parity. Now we will see how this parity generator will be constructed using the combinational circuit design process. As usually we know that five steps. The step one is the problem has to be stated clearly. Yes, we have stated the problem clearly. The parity bit is used to detect the error in the data transmission. Here we are considering the 3-bit parity generator. 3-bit parity generator, and we are considering the even parity mechanism. Even parity mechanism means what? Once the extra bit is added to the actual message, then the number of ones should be even. Then the number of ones should be even. That is what? Even parity. Even parity will make the number of ones in the actual message as even. Now, so this is what the problem statement is. Now, So the problem statement is clearly defined. Now we will move to the second step. The second step is what? We have to identify the input and output variables. Input and output variables. Now, as it is a three variable parity generator, here we require the three input variables. Three input variables. And the output variable is what? Obviously, the parity generator. That is what? Y. That is what? Y. So, for 3-bit binary variable, we will get the 8 combinations. We will get the 8 combinations. The combinations are 00, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, 111. Now, we will see how exactly this even parity was derived. We will see how the values were derived for Y. Now, the first combination. 000. So, in the 000, how many ones are there? Already it is even. So, we no need to add the one additional bit, that is what? 1. So, obviously, the even parity becomes what? 0. Why? Because once you added the extra bit to the actual message, the number of ones should be what? Even. So, if you consider the Y as 1, then it is becomes odd, which is against to the principle. So, obviously, the Y becomes 0. So, let us consider the second combination, 001. So, for how many ones are there? Only one is there. Now, the principle is what? The number of ones in the total message should be even. That means we have to add one more 1 bit to make the number of ones in the actual message even. So, like that, we have to continue so that the truth table will be developed. The truth table will be developed. In the truth table, you will have the three input variables A, B, C, and you will have the one output variable, that is what? Y. So, three steps are over in the combinational circuit design process. So, we have stated the problem clearly. We have identified the input and output variables. We have assigned the letters. And we have draw the relationship between the input and output variables. Now, as the truth table is formed, now is the time to, we have to derive the Boolean function for the Y. Why? Because here Y is the what? The output variable. For this output variable, we have to derive the Boolean function. So, first we have to identify for what minterms the Y becomes 1. Here the Y is 1 for the combination of 001, 010, 100, 101, and 111. So let us plot these values on the three variable K map. Three variable K map. As the number of input variables in the 3-bit parity generator combinational circuit problem is 3, so we are using the what? Three variable K map A. So let us plot the values. Let us plot the values as the values were plotted. Now we have to group the ones. There is no chance for group of 4 ones. There is no chance for group of 2 ones. The reason is the ones are not contiguous. Now obviously we have to encircle it with the choice of what? 1. So we will have the 4 single ones. So let us find out the terms for it. For the first one, A bar, B bar, C, plus for the second one, A bar, B, C bar, plus for the third one, A, B bar, C bar, and for the last one, A, B, C. So, this Boolean function can be rewrite so that it can be rewrite as what? C exclusive R, A exclusive R, B. So, we have identified the simplified Boolean function for the given problem. So, let us draw the logic diagram for this. So, first, for the first exclusive R, AB was applied. So, the output of the first exclusive OR gate will be input to the second exclusive OR gate, and we are considering the one more input variable C. So once the output of the AB exclusive OR gate C is connected to the second exclusive OR gate, we will get the y. So children, please remember the steps of the combinational circuit. So five steps are there. First, the problem has to be stated clearly. Second, once the problem is stated clearly, we have to identify the input and output variables. Once the input and output variables were identified, we have to assign the letters or the labels to the input and output variables. Third, for each input combination, we have to see the what will be the output combination. What will be the output combination? The fourth step, for each output variable, we have to derive the Boolean function. Either the Boolean function can be simplified using postulates of the Boolean algebra or Euler, that is what came out. So once the simplified Boolean expression, Boolean function was derived, for which we have to develop the logic. So this is for today's class. Tomorrow we will see the next one. Thank you. Bye. Thank you.